If you found this video, you probably already watched this movie, and chances are that you are wandering around the internet trying to find answers on how to feel about it. Or at least, what is the general consensus regarding this film? I am going to answer that question for you. Most people hated this movie. I, on the other hand, did not. Was I expecting this particular product when I went into it for the first time? Of course not. No one was. The film radically changed the original continuity of the story. You wouldn't put stickers on a Ferrari, right? Sure, there were some twists here and there on the first movie, and about 30% of the story changed on the second one. But basically, on those films, the story was the same. But does that mean that the third one is a bad film? Or a bad story for that matter? Well, let's take a look on what the experts say about this film. This review is probably one of my favorite reviews of all times. Not because of the content, because I disagree with most of it, but because of the terms that the critic used, calling the film a serviceable approach to often substitute obfuscation for complexity. Obfuscation, really. I cannot blame Variety for the use of such terms. After all, this is the same magazine that came out with terms such as sitcom or sex appeal or even striptease. So they always been known for their eloquence, but obfuscation? I am not a native English speaker, but even you must acknowledge that ordinary people do not use these terms on a daily basis. Mooney's psychobabble mythology of this emo mecha epic? It just never gets old. In short, he didn't like it, and overall, the general consensus moved on that same direction. So, where are we now? Well, 8 years has passed and we are on the eve of 3+1 release. So many people decided to take a second look at the third movie, and some of them are changing their perspective, which is good, of course. Myself, probably have watched Reveal 3 at least a dozen times in the past 7 years. I have watched it in Japanese, English and Spanish, with official subtitles, but also with fan subtitles. Also, I have read transcripts of the film. The last time I watched this movie was last week. To be frank, I spent over a year without rewatching it. And I recently made a hot take breakdown on the third teaser for 3+1 released by Kara. It was not an in-depth analysis. Therefore, I decided to revisit the movie again. And yet again, I got a whole different experience. Because of that, I decided to list my top 5 reasons on why I believe The Reveal of Evangelion 3 is a great movie. Now, this is my list. You can disagree with it 100%. I am not the holder of truth. As a matter of fact, I would like to know your list, so let it on the comments down below. Also, if you disagree and think that the whole movie is trash, let me know why. With that being said, let's begin. Number 5. Its introduction. Even the king of the haters has acknowledged this. The first few minutes of the film is a flawless sequence of action scenes, with Asuka in her Eva kicking butt in space. Yes, space, how cool is that? And now she has an eye patch that fits her pretty well. All of that combined with the epic Evangelion score makes it pretty memorable. This sequence is impactful for many reasons. As an audience, we do not know what is going on. What is Asuka doing in space? Why does she have an eye patch? Mari now has its own Eva? What are they savaging? What is the thing that she is fighting? We do not know at this point of the movie. What we do know is that something is off. This is not going to be a continuation on the original storyline. The director made it pretty clear with this sequence, which in my opinion is one of the best combat sequences that I have ever seen on anime, and the best one on the Evangelion franchise so far. Number 4. New character designs. I already mentioned Asuka eye patch, but how about this cap and the jacket? It fits her and her personality pretty well. Also, the rag red plug suit is letting us know that she has gone through a lot with limited resources. It just adds to her mythos. Misato now has a grimmer and more serious look. I mean, 14 years has passed, and she failed on her lifelong mission to prevent a third impact. Now, she's in charge of a whole new organization and an inexperienced personnel. makes sense that the now Captain Katsuragi just grew her dark side. Her obsession now overtook her persona. Not a fan on Dr. Akagi's short hair, I must say, but she always being an introvert. This is the apocalypse now, who has time for fashion? It's all about being effective. And if every morning you can save up 20 minutes combing your hair to save the world, it is good on my account. The Wily personnel has a variety of designs. We can all agree that in the original run, all characters follow the same pattern. But now they all look different, like people in real life does. Yes, some of them look cartoonish, but hey, also do I, and I'm a real human being, I think. And even though Shinji, Rei, and Kaoru look basically the same, the neo-futuristic glasses of Gendo Ikari adds to his madness. Now he is a cyberpunk villain. Yes, I love the classic orange tinted glasses as much as the next guy, but hey, we're living in the future now, we have to keep up with the times. Number 3. New foes. Historically, the Angels have served as the main antagonist of the franchise. And they still are, just in a different way. Yes, of course, we also had Seal and Gendo Ikari fulfilling that role, but they have served more as masterminds behind the scenes. No one was expecting them to bring huge and impactful action scenes as only Angels and Evas can bring. Now we have two big factions fighting against each other, Nerve and the newly introduced Wily. Of course, we side with Wily because every character that we love from the original storyline are now part of that organization. Even though that Shinji goes into an existential dilemma once again and sides with Nerve, we know these are the bad guys. Other types of Evangelion units are now the main threat. Now there is a lot of speculation on how Nerve was able to mass produce all these EVAs. The most popular one is that these EVAs used to be people. Yes, people. And after Shinji started the Third Impact, in the second movie, people exposed to the core became kind of a hybrid between an angel and an EVA, as their souls were unable to complete instrumentality. And even though this theory is fascinating to say the least, reality is that we don't know for sure. It's only a theory that came from something that Kaoru said. What we do know is that Wily's purpose is the destruction of Nerve and its EVAs, as Misato stated on the first act of the film. In this movie, it was established that EVAs can take different forms, as we see different types of them. This is also confirmed on the teasers that have been released over the past year. I mean, we had EVAs capable of fighting in space. Imagine the possibilities of that. Number 2. Kaoru and Shinji relationship. Finally, after all these years, we have a proper development of their relationship. I just made a video about Kaoru on the original run, and in order to develop his character and role on it, I had to pull out information from the extended lore, as he only appeared for 13 minutes on the entire story. 13 minutes, that's it. Yes, he was then reintroduced on the director's cut on the last two episodes, and yes, he appears on the end of Evangelion. But does this add to his character development or his relationship with Shinji? That is the real question. For me, the answer is a big fat no. Now we have a proper development of the character, and more important, his fondness towards Shinji now makes more sense. Shinji is on the brink of a mental breakdown before meeting Kaoru, just like on the original storyline. Reasons are a little bit different now. A time skip, a changed Asuka, Misato threats, he's completely left in the dark. Just as the audience is at this point. But then Kaoru appears with answers. He's the only one in this movie that is kind to Shinji. He's the only one that understands him, that listens to him. Now the relationship is more believable, and Kaoru's role is more important. Yes, he's still an angel, but his purposes are different. He's not trying to destroy humanity, but to save it. This way he can save Shinji. Now we can argue all you want about hidden agendas and fan theories. However, his portrayal and his character development in the film was something that obviously Hideki Anno wanted to address after long time due. Number 1. New lore. Let's address the big elephant in the room, the changes made to the original storyline. Back in the day, when Hideki Anno announced the pre-production of Reveal of Evangelion, he stated that was going to be a retelling of the story with a whole different ending, and most people took that for granted. When audiences went to watch the movie, they were expecting just that, a retelling of the original story with an alternative version of what the end of Evangelion is. As a business decision, it made sense. It was not the 90s anymore, Evangelion is a worldwide phenomenon. The author needed to streamline the story, make it simpler to understand, be more coherent, fill plot holes, answer and answer questions that the original storyline left behind. And that he did on the first two movies. Also, he had a pretty decent idea on what he was going to do with the remaining two. But Anno being Anno changed that and gave us a whole different experience. Saw an opportunity to tell a different story and he took it. Yes, the decision was risky. The original story was a masterpiece. But Hideaki Anno is a very talented director and storyteller. Also is his team. They went for it and gave us a new story, a new universe. Will 3 plus 1 be able to fill all the plot holes and contradictions that the third movie left behind? I don't know the answer to that. The fact is that he is establishing new lore, a new continuity, a whole new universe. I am very glad that he did, because now we have an alternative story. The old question on what would have happened if Shinji would have stopped instrumentality earlier was answered. This is the result. That doesn't mean that I prefer this storyline over the original one, but you know, the original story was already told. It's there. The original characters that we all love and cherish are still there, and we can love and praise them for hours. Especially now that they are more accessible than ever since Netflix got the license. Back in that day, it was almost impossible to watch this content. The first time I watched the end of Evangelion was on a videotape that some friend lent me back in high school. It was really difficult to find. We are so lucky now with digital content and everything that the internet brings. Alright guys, I'm starting to geek out, so I'm just gonna leave it there. I am currently on the production of a set of videos regarding reveal of Evangelion. If you haven't subscribed to the channel, please consider doing so. Drop a like on this video if you did. I will see you all pretty soon. Have a wonderful day.